Dear students, Assalamualaikum. Today we'll talk about the idiomatic expressions. It's page number 18, that is of your book. Now, what is an idiom? It might be a new word for you, but anyhow, it is also a type of figurative language, and it also refines the things. Idiom in English language are a type of figurative language. A figurative expression is one whose meaning has no relation to the words in a phrase. They use creative descriptions to share an idea of feeling. Idioms help us to promote fluent and ready response. Learn the following idioms and use them in daily conversation. Definitions are given to understand the meaning. Learn and practice the idioms to enhance your fluency of speech. In your syllabus, girls, I have only included the meanings. You can use them in your own sentences, but that will not be given in exams. You can use them in sentences. Number one idiom that is given over here is can't make head or tails out of something. The meaning of that is not be able to understand something. When you are not able, for example, long speech is delivered by a certain person, but you are not able to gain the meanings what actually he wants to say, then you can say that I can't make heads or tails out of this. She talks and talks, but I can't make heads or tails out of it. That is written in your book. So the meaning of this idiom is when you are not able to understand something. Long speeches, long expressions that are there, but you are unable to understand that. Then the idiom that can be used is can't make heads or tails out of this, out of something. Then number two, that is have a good head on your shoulders. This is very clear. It means good head means when you are very intelligent. Be intelligent. When you are intelligent, have a good head on your shoulder. For example, you can make the sentence like that. That she has a good head on her shoulders. It means that she is very intelligent. When you want to say that she is very intelligent, you can use this idiom. Have a good head on your shoulder. Now number three, that is from head to toe. It means dressed or covered in something completely. From head to toe. The girl was covered from head to toe. Means from one point to the last point, from head to toe, dressed or covered in something completely. Next idiom that is given in your book is get your head above water. Keep going in life despite many difficulties. Now imagine yourself if you are swimming in water. Unless and until your head is above water, you can fight against the waves of water. Similarly, when the life that goes on in spite of many difficulties. So you can make the sentence like that. Despite many difficulties, she get her head above water. She could fight the difficulties. She had many problems in life, but she is going on. Now next is buries one head in the sand. To ignore something completely. Something happens and then you ignore that thing. That is, for that thing, this idiom is used, that is buries one's head in the sand. As some animals, they bury their head in the sand. And they are not able to face the difficulties. Yes, whenever she sees the problems, she buries her head in the sand. We can use that in a sentence like that. Whenever she sees problems, she buries her head in the sand. Then we come to the next. Drum something into someone's head. Repeat over and over until someone learns something, like your teachers. They go on repeating the things. So the lazy bluffers, the students who are not at all interested in studies, who are sitting on the back benches, the back, who are sitting in the, at the back and just discussing something else with their friends, they may also learn something. So drum something into someone's head means to repeat the things again and again, so until someone, the people who are not very attentive, they may also learn the things. I think this will be clear to all of you. Now try to use these idioms in your daily speech also. Then we come to the last chapter. This is page number 19. Number one, speech act. That is polite and friendly request. You can do practice of this with your friend as well as with your brother or sister or with your mother. Now look at the dialogue. Can you please take care of my dog for an hour? Oh no, I'm scared of animals. Come on, he's a friendly dog. He'll play with you. Take this ball. Are you sure? Let me first try the ball trick. It seems to be a good dog. Don't worry, you'll like him. He seems to be a good dog. And a picture is also given where a dog that is playing. So it is actually a practice of dialogue's delivery. How to deliver certain words. How to talk. Because as I have told you in earlier, the basic objective of this book is to increase your skills. Reading, speaking, writing, comprehension. So by speaking, you increase the skill of your speaking. And by comprehension, you also increase the skill how to comprehend certain message. So this is also same kind of practice. But practice makes a man perfect. So you have to do the practice with your brother, with your sister, with your mother, with your father, to make yourself perfect. Otherwise, there is no use of this activity. Then we come to the next. This is fun reading. You can see that this is the picture of a clock. What has hands but can't clap? It is a clock. Yes, the needles that are there in the clock, they are called as the hands. That is why a clock has hands, but obviously it can't clap. Now here at the bottom of the page, a flyer is given. Flyer, which we have earlier talked about flyers. Plant a tree, plant a new life. Now very precise, very short message, but having a great impact on the people. So the message of all this chapter was that we have to make our country clean as well as green. We have to plant trees to overcome pollution as well as to eliminate poverty from our country, to increase the income of our country. Similarly, some other things have also been discussed over there in the chapter, and we will discuss that tomorrow, inshallah. I think it's enough for today's. Thank you very much.